One of the most interesting data storage options that Android provides you is shared preferences. So, in this session, we will learn how to save data using shared preferences and how to listen to changes if preferences get changed. What is shared preferences? Shared preferences is one of the ways in which you would basically store and retrieve small pieces of primitive data type, such as string, ints, floats, booleans, that make up your preferences in an XML file inside the app on the device storage. Shared preferences really can be thought of as a dictionary or a key value pair. So, for example, you might have a key being username, and for the value, you might store the user's username, and they would put that in there, and then you could retrieve that value by a key. It is just like using a dictionary. You have a simple shared preferences API that you can use to store preferences and pull them back out. Shared preferences is suitable in different situations. For example, when user settings needs to be saved or to store data that can be used in different activities within an app. As we have already know that on pause will always be called before your activity is placed in the background or destroyed. So, for the data to be saved persistently, we prefer saving it in on pause, which could be restored in onCreate of the activity. As we already know that onPause will always be called before your activity is placed in the background or destroyed. So, for the data to be saved persistently, we prefer saving it in onPause, which could be restored in onCreate of the activity. These are small pieces of data stored with a key value pair and is kept private within the scope of the application. But shared preferences are different from the activity instance state that you learned about in the previous sessions. Let's see how. Data in shared preferences will be persistent even if the user closes the application or apps get killed and restarted or the device is rebooted. Shared preferences values will persist across user sessions. There are the things that you would have in an application to store some kind of settings that a user would set. That's the basic idea of preferences. So the data can be remembered across the sessions. Perhaps they could set some preferred settings like login details or the game score. And on the other hand, save instance state, the data will be preserved for the same user session across the activity instance and not remembered across different sessions, which we commonly use. The states get recreated either after the device gets rotated or some configuration changes has been made. So, how do we create our shared preferences? The first thing that we are going to do is to create one shared preferences file that can be accessed via all application components. So name it with the package name of your app to make it unique and easy to associate. And when you wanted to get the values from shared preferences, use getSharedPreferences method. Shared preferences provides modes of storing data inside the shared preferences file, such as the private mode and the public mode. I suggest you to store the data inside the shared preferences file in the private mode. To get an instance of shared preferences, use the getSharedPreferences method. The method takes two parameters, the name of the preference settings, that is the shared preferences file, and the mode. If you want to edit or save any value to shared preferences file, we need to get the reference to the shared preference editor. So, this editor basically is an interface that allows you to edit the data inside the shared preferences file and take care of all the file operations. And whatever changes you are going to make inside the editor, that will be reflected back in the shared preferences file once you call the apply method in this editor object to save the data safely. So, this is how we save the data in onPause. Call edit to get a shared preferences editor instance and add the data with methods such as putInt to store integer value with the key. Here we are adding two integer values as preferences, and finally call apply to save all the values in the shared preferences. Now, to restore the values on onCreate of activity, use such methods as getSharedPreferences or getInt of shared preferences instance to get an access to the preferences stored in the file. Get method will take two arguments, the key and the default value. In case the key is not found, the default argument value will be used. So we don't have to test our preferences exist in the file. Use SharedPreferences getSharedPreference method. This method gets SharedPreferences from a specified file, and this is how we read the values from it. If you want to give users the ability to clear any preferences you may have saved, it's easy to be done. Once you get an instance of the editor, you just call clear on it. That will remove all the values from the preferences. You still need to call apply to apply the changes after you have cleared the preferences. Also, if you set any preferences and hit clear together, however, to apply the changes, clear method will always be called first. So this is how you can clear the preferences. Android uses a single instance of the preference file within a same application. This means that if you open the same preference file twice, for example, in two different activities at the same time, every change that you apply using one object will immediately be reflected in the other object. So, if you change a preference within an activity, you need a method to notify the other components of your application using the same preference file that the change has occurred. So, in order to listen to changes, you have to follow these steps. Implement the shared preferences on shared preference changelist interface within your component first. Then, register the listener with the register on shared preference changelistener method on shared preferences. Now, where will you register this? You register the listener in the appropriate methods, like on onResume of the activity. And to unregister the listener, you will unregister it in onPause of the activity. Now, override the method onSharePreferenceChanged in order to listen to preference changes. So this is how we implement the onSharePreferenceChangeListener interface and onSharePreferenceChange callback method. And this is how you can listen to changes in the preferences via the register onSharePreferenceChangeListener method onSharePreferences. Now you know that another component of your app has just changed the value of the current preferences. You need a strong reference to the listener, as weak reference objects get garbage collected in a garbage collection pass. On the other hand, strong references are the references that you use all the time. It doesn't let garbage collection free up the objects. Let's say you register a onSharePreferenceChangeListener with the preference manager. The preference manager will store it as a weak reference. This means that whenever the garbage collection strikes, the listener object will get collected, as there is no stored references anywhere to the listener object. As a result, the preference manager will lose the weak reference it holds to the listener you registered, and you won't get any preference change callbacks thereafter. When registering the listener, the preference manager doesn't store a strong reference to the listener. You must store a strong reference to the listener or it will be susceptible to garbage collection. Keep a reference to the listener in the instance data of an object that will exist as long as you need the listener. Here is an app overview which you are going to work within your practical, where you will start with the starter app and add shared preferences. You will also add a reset button that sets both the count and the background color to the default and clears the preferences file. Isn't it interesting? Learn more from these links and do the practical now. Thanks for watching.